Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and we are finally here at the third episode of New-TNA. I'm Zach Shore, he's Frank Doug, he's Steven.
We're finally here for the third episode after a brief hiatus. There's going to be a huge contract signing tonight between Jimmy Spade and Mr. Anderson for the Unsanctioned Match against all odds. Ryan Rex made a shocking debut that needs to be discussed as he was revealed to be Oshujax's newest protege and defeated number one contender AJ Styles for the TNA Championship of the Life IMPACT. What's going to happen here tonight?
Yeah, he did defeat AJ Styles, but not before Oshujax assaulted AJ Styles before the match. And that's what's going to happen here tonight. I know for a fact we have a huge street fight planned later on between between Douglas Williams and Jeff Hardy.
That would be a great match.
Douglas Williams has made a gentleman's challenge to Jeff Hardy in Jeff Hardy's own signature match style and attempt to shake off the ring run.
Think of the French Invasion and Douglas Williams, Kurt Angle will take on Samoa Joe in the second match of the Best of Five series.
Both these men are hell-bent on proving which one of them is truly the best wrestler in the world today. That's what this match is all about. Speaking of AJ Styles, here he comes now.
AJ Styles looking big here in New TNA, kind of. So, gotta give him some props.
I'm surprised I know he said wild or recuperate, but I'm still surprised he's able to come out here on his own. I mean, he just took a hellacious beating, not just from Oshujax, but also in his match against Ryan Rex that same night.
Well, you gotta remember from the last Impact, as you were saying, Oshujax did attack AJ Styles from last week for his match, so I guess AJ has something to say to Oshujax.
But AJ does have a bit of momentum back in his corner after an impressive win against Jason Matthews on the last explosion, despite his young opponent's best attempts. AJ still walked out victorious.
Yes, he's going to roll in some momentum again. Maybe be in Jason Matthews in last week's look.
Fans are big support of AJ Styles here tonight.
That's exactly what I said. I can't believe it was just really proud of what he did to AJ. Damn, skip it.
It's our honorable champion, he's now quoting.
That's right, he did say that he would defend the title against the entire roster to prove that he was a fighting champion.
He's just saying that he's disgracing the world title.
Honestly, I can't disagree.
You gotta do whatever it takes to keep your title. Even put the time limit on it, even though it wasn't fair. Oshujax did what he did, and he's still the champion.
Well, that's true. He is still the champion, but you can't make comments about how you're a fighting champion and then take cheap shots at your opponents the whole time. There's a difference between holding on to your title and having your title honorably.
Well, AJ Styles saying he is coming for his Oshujax world title.
It'll be a match against these two, against all odds, and I can't wait to see. I can't wait to see AJ Styles finally get his hands on Oshujax one on one.
He's just sick of it.
And showing their support for AJ, they agree with his theory.
Anywhere.
It's interesting. That's a good thing about false handling. Just like AJ Styles is saying, yeah, there's no time limits. There's no way to get disqualified.
It's nothing. It's nothing. I mean, fall count anywhere can mean anything.
Something I admit is that AJ does hold a pinfall victory over Oshujax from the first Impact. Wait, here we go.
It's Daniels. Is that? Yeah. Daniels!
What the hell is he doing out here?
Daniels, I forget Daniels, he was out after the first Impact when Mr. Anderson gave him a concussion during their match. It's good to see Daniel's back.
Hopefully Fallen Angel out here. The fans are wondering as well.
Well, he did Daniel's did win the match, but he still suffered a serious concussion. Rousseau said he'd gladly defend his world title against Daniels. Oh, it's going to be good to hear.
Daniels is saying he's doing great after the first impact. And he can't wait to see AJ kick Ocean Jack's ass.
Okay. Daniels feels that Ocean Jack's is a thorn in his side too. And he got to admit, Daniels says that Ocean agrees with AJ's logic that Ocean Jack's is disgracing the world title.
Wait, hang on. Daniels apparently has something else he needs to talk about.
Ryan Rex.
Damn, calling out the Rex.
Fans are on their feet now in shock.
Well, what's this got to do with it? What's this got to do with Ryan Rex?
Oh, good book. Daniel full face Anderson on explosion. And the botch.
Can't stand Ursendax.
Or his proteges.
Like Daniels agrees that he too does not like the proteges of Oshujax either.
Oh, production crew. I agree with Daniels and Styles. Or Styles and Styles apparently. Oshujax isn't really trying to teach them the three of them anything. He just wants to He just needs somebody to cover his back to hit, so he can keep the title on himself.
He's saying that he's going to help out AJ. Maybe these two men will probably team up and take out Oshujax and Ryan Rex.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute!
Here comes the devil. Here comes the world champion himself, Oshujax, and his protege, Ryan Rex.
Oshujax coming out here maybe to make a statement.
I would love for an act to face Daniels for the tag title. Not this guy, Oshujax.
Oh, God damn it, SX. Get out here, Stephen Hawkins. Honey and Marie.
Ocean Dad doesn't even care about these two men teaming up.
Best friends forever.
He doesn't really believe it. He doesn't even really believe or care about their friendship or the idea that either of them could pose a threat to him.
Ocean Jack's world champion here, a new impact. And that is right, Ryan Rex did beat him in the middle of the ring last week.
Not without help from Oshujax beforehand, though, don't forget.
You gotta think that maybe the ego of Ryan Rex is rubbing off of Oshujax.
Yeah, I mean, you hang around somebody as big-headed as Oshujax, and Oshujax tells you you're something special, and it probably starts to swell your head as well. Oshujax saying that Styles is the one that needs to run away.
Say he's going to regret it. Will AJ regret it?
And it's all a matter of time.
Only time will tell.
Last impact. That is right.
He did take it to AJ Styles, but again, AJ Styles was pointing
wait.
Here.
Ryan Rex is called of Christopher Daniels here now.
Oh my.
Perhaps maybe he shouldn't be overlooking Mr. Kenneth Anderson.
Mr. Kenderson, yeah. Hmm. Yeah, Moran Max is making a mistake in that. I was taking five shots at Anderson's.
At Anderson? For being the one that took Daniels out.
Saying it's his funeral.
Grandmother, he's accepting his challenge.
Yeah, he's not warning Chris. Don't want to mess with Ryan Rex.
Typing going on.
Oh man! Wait, hey, it's Teddy Long.
What the?
Strong words by Teddy Long by Ryan Rex, but now apparently Teddy Long has other plans. Keen observation powers of our general manager.
I have a feeling Teddy Long's going to make a bombshell announcement here tonight.
Or two. Ooh, a match added to against Owens.
One-on-one. Christopher Daniels. Wow.
That is going to happen. Nice main event.
There's a main event for tonight. Oh, we're going to go some tag team action. Oshujax, Ryan Rex. Oh, my.
The Angels reunite.
What a man event. Thank you, Teddy Long, for this.
Wait. Thank you, Teddy. Thank you,
please,
Teddy.
Please. Crowds are on their feet for this lovely man event tonight.
Crowd is excited.
Going up next, we're going to have a handicap match. Suspect.
It's like, yeah, the Million Dollar Congregation is reunited to take on Steve Spider.
And the Mystery Partner.
Yes, the Mystery Partner. We didn't know him, though. It could be anyone. I remember the Million Dollar Congregation. This all started a little while back when, This all started a while back when Hulk interfered with a match when Spider had a match with Jay Lethal and cost Spider the victory. Because Spider really just destroyed Suspect after Suspect defeated Spider on the first explosion. It gave Suspect a minor leg injury that caused him to miss out on the...
You gotta think, though, that this man, Steven Spider, is gonna try to make that minor injury an even bigger injury here tonight.
Absolutely. I mean, you gotta think Steven Spreader, they're hoping Suspect is trying to make a fool out of him. And so Spreader, he's probably out for blood. I'd be wary if I was anyone stepping into the ring with Steve Spreader in the mood he's in right now. I mean, just look at him. He's all business.
Well, I
has got a team with this man.
Well, you want to know what I really want to know is who is his partner for tonight?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Who would even want a team with Steve Spreader?
Like, I really want to know who's gonna...
I'm just confused.
I want to know who this partner is.
Hope challenge Spreader this tag match.
Yeah, instead of just a one-on-one match.
What's this music?
Wait a
second. Who is this?
Hey.
I think it's lights are out. What's going on here?
It can't be.
What do you mean it can't be? I've never heard this music before. I'm just, what the
hell? Oh my God. It's Michael Tarver.
He's here. The Killshot Dojo is reunited tonight!
Oh my, the former partner of Steven Spreader. I cannot believe this! He's giving him a second chance after his recent actions.
I'm just really surprised that Tarver would reunite with it. We agreed to team back with Spreader after the way Spreader's been acting recently, but Like you said, I guess Tarver's giving him a second chance.
Yes, because remember, Tarver turned his back on Spryder. He lost to the Congregation at Genesis in the number one contenders match. Observing who will face Guns against all odds.
This is a sort of rematch between the Congregation and the Killshot Dojo. Maybe the result will be different this time. Who knows?
The crowd
doesn't know what to think. The crowd's on their feet. And they're just as shocked as we are.
I can't believe Michael Tarver's back. There we go.
All right, going on. We're starting off with the Pope and Spryder, and Spryder just taking to the Pope.
The Pope has his plans.
Nope. Spryder's with a nice shin break if they were on Pope. Already the game making a clear game plan, targeting the legs as he is wont to do.
That could be like you said just now, that could be the whole plan for this match. Just go for the legs.
And you gotta think, if he weakens the legs sufficiently, Pope can't really go for the DDE.
Oh, nice uppercut by Spryder.
Solid uppercut indeed by Spryder, just rocked him on his feet. Now an elbow drop to the back. Just really punishing. And D'Angelo.
Wait a minute! Nice counter by the Pope.
Solid DDT counter by the Pope. Had him scouted. Spryder was going for the go to sleep. The Pope had other plans. It was not Pope's bedtime yet. Pope throwing Spryder in the corner. And was back.
Oh, nice.
Pope catching him with a nice hip toss there.
It's a cover.
This is it. One, two. I hope Spryder's going to kick at us out of the hip toss. Solid dropkick there by the Pope. Now Pope going to work on the legs of Spryder.
I guess I could say it's a little payback for what Spryder did.
Giving Spryder a taste of his own medicine. Very nice.
Yes.
Now wait, Spryder with a thumb to the with a poke to the eyes.
Oh, that ain't good. That can cause this match. Oh!
An old school chop lock. Shades of the Nature Boy. Oh, and a knee stomp to the face.
Oh, God, that leg shot had to do it.
Oh. Spryder back in control with his old school style. And now Spryder.
Here comes the man, the former tag partner, Spryder.
And the Black Panther's Harbor.
Harbor, man.
The Black Panther on the arm. Oh, huge big boot. Just turning the Pope inside out. Tarver with a big elbow drop to the head.
Tarver now just showing what he has. He's probably going to prove to Spryder that he might. Oh!
No. That neck breaker of his own.
I think we're going to see some suspect. Is he going to? Yup.
Suspect to this match.
Nice little old-fashioned tag team action.
Anyway, elbow drop there by...
Got a shot in the referee's ass.
Anywho. Ooh, now suspect with an elbow to the back of the head of his own.
That tag move was number 78. For what? Oh!
Suspect with a nice flash kick there. Turnboard off rope.
Wait a minute, off the top rope! Ooh,
that was like... Just move there by suspect.
Here's a cover.
Cover? Can this be it? I wouldn't be surprised. No! Spryder breaks it for the one count. Suspect just barely connects with that corkscrew senton. Now, suspect with a nice enziguri. Carver breaking the eyes.
Oh, whoa!
And that toss.
Carver just manhandling suspect.
And, that senton wasn't really as good as it could have been. I mean, maybe suspect's leg is still bothering him. He might not be at 100%. Tarver apparently has the same idea.
Well, that's what we need to figure out. Is suspect 100% for tonight?
I mean, sometimes there's a revenge is an understandable feeling, but sometimes if you're not 100%, you're just not 100%. Well, Tarver and Spryder taking their own try at generic tag move number 78.
Oh, now he's gonna work on the legs of suspect. This is the plan for the whole night. Just go for the legs.
Trying to re-injure suspects. With the kick right in the ligaments behind the knee.
This is the plan the whole time. Wait a minute. Nice. Oh, whoa! Now, never mind.
No. Suspect out with a neck breaker. Suspect will not let his career be ended so easily. Now, suspect with those measured elbow shots right to the chest.
Yeah, suspect.
Whoa, oh, that, what is this?
Suspect oh. with that snapmare and that hard roundhouse right to the chest there of Spryder. Now it's this.
Oh, Spryder nice.
For suspect with that low clothesline, getting back in control.
This
is keeping his corner game, so to speak.
Ooh.
Nice shoulder tackles in the corner. Standing to wear Spryder down.
God.
Suspect really just...
He's just taking his Spryder now. He's just going to torture him. If he just keeps him in that corner with the poop and suspect, they're just going to gang up on him the whole time.
Yeah, it's going to be quick tags all over this place. You know, Spryder is... I think they're finally giving Spryder a taste of what he deserves. They're just laying it on him. Nope, Spryder, still as cunning and talented as he is, he's able to fight out of it. With this, drop toe hold. Very impressive there by Spryder. Oh wait, Suspect's got him.
This is nice tag action. Nice little teaming up. Oh, nice kick to the gut by the Pope and the Spryder. Wait a minute. Oh! Yes.
Sit out jawbreaker there by the Pope. Very nice.
Wait a minute.
Wait, what's this? Running drop kick right to the face of Spryder.
Generic black guy move. Oh,
have a nice run. Another running drop kick to the head of Spryder.
It's not looking good for Spryder at all.
Spryder just getting beat like a redheaded stepchild.
And see what I tell you? They're just going to keep him in the corner and just do quick tags.
That assisted cross body.
Suspect
now back in control. Suspect getting his revenge on Spryder for trying to...
Wait a minute, counter! Cross body by Spryder.
I think he made a belly-to-belly suplex there. But all the same, very nice move there by Spryder, getting back in control of this match.
Oh, now just going to work on the armor.
Arm ring and leg drop across the arm of Suspect.
Now he's just going to work on the arm of Suspect. Maybe not go for the leg this time, but yeah. Here comes the big man Tarver.
I mean, it's just as important when you're looking at a guy like... A guy like Suspect, when you're considering Suspect's strategy... Go after the legs and the arms.
One, two! Pope breaking up the pin. Nice.
And
Oh my god.
As I said, Tarver and the Spryder, they need to work on the arms, because when you look at a guy like...
Oh!
A guy like Suspect, what his entire strategy is based on the lariat, it's important to focus on the arms and the legs, because if he doesn't have the arm, he can't deliver the lariat as strongly.
See so, that?
Pope nice shot there by the Pope, trying to take out... That's good tag team wrestling. You've got to keep your eyes on your partner. Tarver got stunned there, which allowed Suspect to come back with the Bulldog. Now Suspect coming back in control of this match.
Oh, Suspect. Suspect's laying the punches on him. Oh, there goes Spryder.
Crashing to the floor. Wait a minute. Suspect coming off the top with the double knee.
Got it. Now here comes the Pope, maybe to get some redemption after that shot. Bulldog.
I'm all over the place in this ring tonight. Running dropping to the face there of Tarver. They're just really gotta use their speed to keep the big man down.
I don't know about him being, well, maybe he's a big man, but,
You know, they just called him the big man, just a while ago.
I don't care what they call him.
Now, Tarver with that side headlock and just battering him with hard shots in the northern area to the back of the head.
Oh, and here comes Spryder now doing this strategy. Right
back to control. This good, solid tag team action.
They're just going to use the quick
yourself getting back in when your partner's in trouble. Spryder got plenty here. He's got a knee to the ribs plan there.
Spryder now off the rope goes the Pope. No, wait.
This.
Oh.
Nice spinning neck breaker there by Spryder. Another old school knee drop. And that's the impressive thing about Spryder. He's able to miss so many... styles of wrestling. It's a creative style entirely unique to himself.
Hey, Pope going off the ropes! Another neck breaker!
Neck breakers, very solid there by Spryder. Spryder and Tarver, the kill shot dojo looks to be back in classic form. They've got this one in hand, looks like. And Spryder, chops.
Oh, now they're just gonna work on the chest. And
Wait a minute.
Here comes Tarver looking for some team action. Oh!
Tarver tagged himself in.
got himself in. He saw an opening, and now he's going to work on the Pope.
He's just working on the head of the Pope now.
He's trying to maybe get Pope a
concussion. Whoa!
Beer! Another good choke toss by Tarver. Dojo looks to have this one. Wait a minute!
Oh, what a counter by the Pope!
Solid reverse STO there by the Pope. Get back in this match.
Seen this before.
Here comes Pope.
Oh my!
Now here comes Suspect. Charge it back into the match. Boom! Down goes Tarver.
And
now Suspect's got him.
Here it comes.
Suspect with the shutterbug.
It has to be over.
That's it. Tarver's out. This could be it. It's all
over. Two, three. Spryder couldn't make it back in time.
Spryder tried to get in, but the Million Dollar Congregation picked another solid win against what would be his last appearance of Killshot Dojo.
Spryder and Tarver just have to learn from their mistakes during this match.
Yeah, could the congregation keep this momentum rolling to become the tag team champions that against all odds they take on the Machine Guns? And I just hope that, you know, whatever problems Tarver and Spryder have after this match, they can all put them in the past. So that Pope and Suspect can focus on the congregation. And I don't know, this might have been the last we ever see in the Killshot Dojo. Again, a really solid win over the Killshot Dojo tonight here for the Million Dollar Congregation. But just a big win that these guys picked up. Really good one. Back, ladies and gentlemen, and we're here with Kurt Angle. That's it.
You see Kurt Angle, I disagree with a lot of his points. I mean, he says wrestling sells alone. I don't think it's wrestling, just wrestling sells alone. It's Douglas Williams and Devin Wolf, they've lived off wrestling in bingo halls the whole career. People like Jeff Hardy, Jeff Hardy, he's wrestled
and that is everything that is wrong with this sport. That a glorified trapeze artist like Jeff Hardy to be as successful as he is, yet talented men like Douglas Williams and Desmond Wolfe get nothing. And you want to talk about how wrestling alone can't draw? Kurt Angle's an Olympic gold medalist and he's a 13-time world champion. That sounds like drawing to me.
Kurt Angle has also been a character too. All these guys live off his wrestling. That just doesn't sell.
Look, the sign of the marquee says wrestling. This company is New-TNA Impact Wrestling. These are professional wrestlers in a wrestling ring. Men like Jeff Hardy need to get that straight if they plan on getting anywhere else in this business
So they get with guys like Desmond Wolfe and Douglas Williams and Kurt Angle set the record straight and grind guys like Jeff Hardy into the dust so we can get up so someone can fix this sport. And it's about time someone got their heads straight.
Oh, those are some lovely words you just gave us, Zach. Thank you.
Oh, good. You're back, Steve.
Guess I had to deal with something quick, but now I'm back. And
that's cool. And I forgot to mention while we were talking about this, Angle was hyping up his match with Samoa Joe in the Best of Five series.
Wait a minute, we're back, see?
What the hell? Scott Sanders is assaulting Matt Morgan. Big Rob Bum's going after the Blueprint. What the hell is this?
What the hell is going on?
Jesus, he just took Matt Morgan out over the couch. I mean, I remember a few impacts ago, they had words. On the last impact, they had a brawl backstage.
Oh, right in the TV.
And now it was Morgan who assaulted. Steiner, and now Steiner is going to the attack on Morgan.
Jeez, Steiner just
killing him. Morgan's defenseless. Oh, jeez.
Wait a minute, this ain't looking too good. Wait a minute! No! Don't do it! No!
Power bomb right to the wall, or power bomb right into the lockers, and geez, double underhook suplex
on the chair.
Why?
This is all about being the bigger and better man in new TNA.
This is all about ego. Like who's bigger? Who's strongest? Who uses the most steroids? Oh, jeez. Smashing him. And
see, now he's just torching Mo.
Yeah, just beating the hell out of him. Oh, man. Morgan's got to be loopy.
This is not good. Wait a minute. No. Oh, dude, no!
Jesus, just crack him in the mouth.
Don't do this. Somebody has to get in there. Somebody has to stop this attack. That man can't breathe.
It's over 100 plus pounds of steel. And Steiner just threw it like it was nothing. It really didn't crush Morgan's windpipe. Wait a minute.
We all got to remember that Steiner holds a pinfall victory over Morgan at Genesis. And then Morgan just still holds a grudge over it.
Morgan not able to accept that. Oh, no.
Oh, no, not this again. No.
God. And there's a reason that they call the man Big Papa Pump. He's one of the most powerful men in the company. Oh, no. Jesus, he threw the trash can inside out.
Oh, my God!
Oh, no, now what's he got planned? I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. I'm just dragging Morgan around. Wait a minute.
Oh, no, we see this.
The recliner!
Oh, my God, he's just holding it in. Somebody has to get here. Stop this!
He's out cold.
All right, stop it.
Well, up next we have the street fight between Jeff Hardy and Douglas Williams. This is Douglas Williams' first match in quite some time. Williams hoping to shake off the ring rust.
I'm sure we're ready for this match. And here comes that man, Jeff Hardy.
Here comes the Antichrist professional wrestling himself, Jeff Hardy. And as I mentioned earlier in the show, Douglas Williams made this match as a gentleman's challenge to Jeff Hardy, even giving Jeff Hardy the benefit of a match more suited to Jeff Hardy's daredevil style.
Yes, and Jeff Hardy has like been involved between so many feuds, like Wolfie. Jeff Hardy previously defeated.
He defeated Desmond Wolfe to start a new TNA, but Wolfe was able to defeat Jeff Hardy at Genesis with the help of a returning Douglas Williams. The two would form the British Invasion, and they've been feuding ever since. Hardy has actually told Williams that he's going down this path with Desmond Wolfe will bring out nothing good for Williams.
Williams refused to believe everything, and then that Demis Wolf just like winds up.
Oh my God!
Delirium out of nowhere! God, that's the one that broke Kurt Angle's neck!
Holy shit!
Came out of nowhere!
I almost just pissed myself!
I'm sure you hear that, but my guy is dismantling Jeff Hardy. Now look at this, look at this. Celtic not shades of Spit Finley! This wolf just came out of nowhere. He's assaulting Jeff Hardy before Douglas Williams even gets his chance to come out. He's just laying in Hardy. Hardy's defenseless. Somebody get... Hardy had no idea what was coming! Oh!
Williams is taking it out on Hardy now.
Wolf was just destroying Hardy with that curve stomping. Man, Hardy doesn't even probably know where he is. I mean, just, oh! And
That's a knee to the side of the face.
He's out. He's out. Plain and simple. Hey, now what the hell's he got planned? And look at this. An arm capture. Camel clutch there by Destin Wolf. Just working over.
Does this have anything to prove? What is William trying to prove? What do you think William has to prove here tonight?
I don't think it has anything to do with just proving something. It has to do with hurting Jeff Hardy. Wolf
Jesus.
Just saw Hardy for his partner, Doug Williams, when Williams actually makes his way down here. I mean, really, Williams just have to pick up the scraps. Now look at this, exploder suit. Oh. Jesus Christ. Do we have one security guy?
We need security out here. This match is not officially started yet, I don't believe.
I mean, of course this match isn't officially started. Destin Wolf isn't Hardy's opportunist. I mean, Hardy's just Destin Wolf just taking Jeff Hardy apart.
Wait a minute.
It's going on the top open. Oh, a diving clothesline. Oh, man. Hardy just getting destroyed here.
Somebody needs to get out here and stop this.
Hardy can't fight for himself in this condition. Wait a minute. Oh, that might have hurt his jaw. Oh, my God.
Hardy's jaw must be broken.
Jaw, his neck, his brain. God, he's getting annihilated out here.
Oh, he's setting him up.
Wait a minute. He's setting him up. Here it comes.
Oh, shit.
No, the Tower of London. The Tower of London and
Tower of London. Oh,
Jesus. That's it. Hardy's got to be out of it. Really, all Douglas Williams has to do is pin him at this point. Destin Wolf just destroyed.
The fans are worried about Jeff Hardy now. They're just on their feet seeing if he's okay. And wait a minute.
And now here comes Doug Williams. Pick up the scraps.
After two jawbreaker lariats in entire London, how in the hell is Jeff Hardy going to fight back?
I don't know. I mean, I know I didn't have necessarily the nicest things to say about Jeff Hardy, but the guy just has a will that's borderline unmatched in this business. So if anyone could fight back after an assault like that, it might be Jeff Hardy. And Douglas Williams taking his time down, walking in the ring, that might be a mistake on Williams' part that will give Hardy just enough time to recuperate.
I don't think.
At least Williams,
he knows that Jeff Hardy has to be out now after that brutal attack.
Yeah, you're right. It's a miracle that Jeff Hardy is even standing already, but,
I guess the referee got Jeff Hardy to stand up, get ready for this match, but I don't think Jeff Hardy's in any condition to compete now.
Regardless of whether or not he is, man, this is a street fight. There are no rules, and...
Fans are on their feet now, getting ready for this match.
Yeah, I don't know how long they should stay on their feet, though, because... Oh, my! Knee to the face. Looks like his partner. Williams is stomping Hardy, and this is all excessive when you think about it. I mean, Hardy's really got nothing left, and look at this, what's this?
Oh!
First figure four leg lock is taking Hardy apart.
Tribute to Ric Flair.
Not the best way I'd want to see a homage for Ric Flair. Wait, now Williams is locking in a key lock on Hardy.
Jeez, now he's just gonna... Wait a minute, what's this?
What's this?
Oh!
Huge running knee to the face.
Jeez, that ain't gonna...
We're just toying with Jeff Hardy.
Wait a minute. You set him up.
This.
Wait, the Revolution! DDT!
DDT! Oh, yeah, just dropped Hardy on his head.
Revolution DDT, he hits it. Now just go for the pin and stop this chaos. He's not proving anything after that attack. I mean, Jeff Hardy's already down and out.
Williams, the Fujiwara armbar. I don't think he really needs anything to has to prove anything. It's just a matter of just taking Hardy apart. Just toying with him.
Jeez. Now he's just going to take it to him. I mean, what?
This neckbreaker. Oh, Jesus.
What a neckbreaker by... Oh, now he's just going to...
Now he's just going to choke him. Oh, man.
He's just choking the life out of him now.
Well, Williams said he had ring rust, so I guess this is just his way of getting rid of that ring rust. Just taking his sweet time and really polishing off his moveset. Man, that's not the most admirable way to get back in control.
Wait a minute.
Oh, Romero stretch! Oh!
That is not good at all for Hardy.
Nothing is good at all for Hardy. Someone! EMTs! Anyone!
I need to get out here and stop this. This man is
half dead!
Yes! How the fuck is he good for him?
How is any of this good for... Wait a minute. Dragon suplex. Somebody, anybody, stop this madness.
Somebody has to get out here and stop this. Where the fuck is security?
Security, EMTs, the 82nd Airborne. Somebody, anybody, somebody save him. Well, Will was just punching the hell out of Hardy.
Oh, God.
My God. William was just taking his sweet time with Hardy, just... He knows he's in control. He knows there's no way Hardy could possibly fight back. And he's just getting this... And, Williams is just taking him apart right now. And he knows that he could do anything he wanted, and there's no way that Hardy could possibly fight back at this point in the match.
This is just too much for Hardy. I mean, what does this have to prove?
Wait a minute, what the hell? This super suplex.
Now he's just taunting, like, somebody, the ref needs to stop this match.
Ref, somebody, anybody.
Wait a minute, I think he's setting him up.
Onto the top rope,
bombs
away!
There it is! End
please tell me this is the end of it. One, two, don't kick out three. Oh.
We all knew that Jeff Hardy couldn't compete, so basically this is not a win for Williams at all.
You try to explain that to Williams. I'm going to be over here. I mean, really just deplorable tactics by the British invasion tonight.
I mean, wow. Hey, the guy comes out, the...
Shocking. I know that I was in favor of what the British invasion and angle were trying to do, but if this is the way they go about doing it, then I just can't approve of this in particular. Hey, wait.
Oh, Teddy Long.
Hi, CeeLo.
Wait a minute.
Trey Owens. Trey Owens wants to holler at Teddy.
Back to Division Champion.
Trey Owens is asking for something. That's right, last week, the opener of the show, Trey Owens pinned Oshujax in the middle of the ring, 1, 2, 3.
He wants a title shot!
What? He wants a shot? He wants a world title match?
Are you shitting me?
Jesus. Well, that's right. Hey, Long, think about having Oshujax's words come back to bite him.
What?
Oh, that's it! That's
it!
Oh
my,
it's sign!
It's official!
Oh, and it's a double-edged sword. If Trey Owens is able to pull off his title win for his world title,
he'll
go double duty at against all odds.
I wish I was a wrestler. I could just go and ask for a title shot and get it. That was pretty easy for him. Whoa, Jason Matthews!
Hey, Jason Matthews.
We got conversation.
I can't say it. Anyway, these two just... What? You think Jason Matthews might be,
Well, you have to say, and yet, I don't really want to take away from what's going on right now, but you have to agree that, this might be the reason why Oshujax get pissed off at Teddy so much, Steve. I mean, it's kind of easy for anybody to get a title shot against Oshujax. You just have to have some kind of victory over him. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I mean, what? I think Jason Matthews is just jealous now that he gets Trey Owens has got a world title shot against all odds.
But he still wants an Jason Matthews doesn't really seem jealous to me. He just wants that X Division title. I mean, maybe he just seems arrogant about the whole ordeal. Like he'll just walk in against all odds and be the victor. Yeah, he's saying to keep that belt nice and shiny for him against all odds. Telling Owens what to do. And then Spider, now the kill shot Dojo haven't worked. Like I told you, this could be the last time they get together. Well, then, Steve Spider's mad. And there's just back and forth, and Spider saying that him, Oshujax, is nothing. And I mean, that Tarver is nothing. Spider saying it's only not facing any prisoner. We're wondering who gave Spider the power to decide who's the weak link. Tarver being a man admitting he made a mistake. You can't really put all the blame on on Tarver's shoulders. It was a tag match. Tarver saying that Riley calling back for help. And next up, pretty soon we're going to have the contract signed between Jimmy Spade and Mr. Anderson. And I just want to mention that there is a specific no contact clause between these two men before their match against the Logs. And really, I think that'd be a good thing because that's a hellacious tornado tag match they had earlier, or they had on Explosion only a few nights ago, that they definitely wouldn't want to fight, because at this rate, I don't even know if they'll make it to against all odds.
Well, you gotta say, like, here we go now with this contract signing, and it's been pretty good.
That's right. They long remind everyone that it is unsanctioned. They can do whatever they want to each other, but New-TNA cannot be held accountable.
Spade and Harrison needs the man to them to come out right now.
Wait, what the hell?
Oh.
Who the hell? What is this?
What?
Hey, it's Jimmy Spade!
With new theme music!
I like it. I like it a lot. The guy's got good taste in music, if nothing else. I mean, and I like the guy from the beginning, but really, this music just helps. No. Crowd slowly behind the youngster. And this all started in him. This is Spade had a problem apparently with Anderson's attitude, and whoa! Anderson will respond with hateful comments, but Greg Gross mocking Spade and borderline racist comments against Spade's best friend, Trey Owens, our X Division champion, when Anderson referred to Owens as the torch monkey.
Fans are on their feet for Spade. And now here comes Mr. Anderson!
The king of the assholes himself, here he comes. Well, like I said, this whole thing started just being a difference in opinions between Anderson and Spider. It's all about an issue of just, not even really so much respect, just Spade has a problem with Anderson, and Anderson just outright hates Spade. He doesn't like Spade. He's just in favor of the green. Anderson can't, for whatever reason, Anderson can't stand Spade, and the feeling is more than usual.
Oh, here we go with the contract signing. Betty Long making a few words. Yes, these two did have bad hatred for one another since Impact started.
It's just been fighting on and off. And Tanner Betty Long said he's getting sick of it. As I said, this match between the two against all odds will be unsanctioned. They can do damage or anything they have to each other, but there will be no legal activities.
No holds barred! No holds barred! There'll be a fight with no rules.
No disqualifications, no countouts, rope breaks, nothing of the kind. What can anything happen to either of these men?
We have to say this, however. I'm now putting this out in the news that new TNA will be not held for liable for any energy sustained during the match. Just in case both men wanted to sue the company, it's not exactly saying that, but there are medical staff that want to help them, so.
Yeah, it's not like they're just going to leave them out there to die, but, you know, if they want to sue the company, let's take that out of the way right now.
Yes. Fans are on their feet. She's kind of hot, but moving on.
Focus on the ring, Steve.
And there we go, Mr. Anderson making the first signature.
Mr. Anderson signs it. Spade signs it.
And now it's official.
Official. The unsanctioned match. Had against all odds.
You have anything to say?
I don't want to know what these guys got to say to each other.
Ah, geez. See what I told you? This Anderson has no respect for Spade or his friend. Anybody.
You gotta give him some credit, Mr. Anderson's a great fighter here. And he's gonna tell him. He's gonna tell Spade that his dream is like a joke. And
he's mocking Trey, the ex-division champion, Trey Owens, with a black general manager 5 feet away from him.
Man, now.
Now Jimmy Spade is born. Anderson's putting his focus back on Spade.
That's what I was talking about. It's just a dream. He's just saying it's a dream. He needs to quit living at it. He needs to know that this is reality, and everything will go at all against all odds. And these two men.
Anderson's saying against all odds. He's gonna wake him up. Saying that Spade doesn't belong in TNA. And just Anderson saying no one cares about Team Spade. And as far as I can tell from the crowd, I'm not going to be farther from the truth.
Like, I don't really care to see how much Anderson's going to beat him up and make him cry.
Oh, man, I don't like where this is going one bit. Oh, that's terrible, but I can't help but laugh.
That was great. I love
it. What? Or if you get fired, well, that's just fucked up this whole match, wouldn't it?
Oh my, this is great.
Ooh.
And he's just an asshole.
Yeah, damn.
I never heard Spade sound like that before.
He's sick of Anderson. He's just sick of him, but I don't know why he has to be sick of him. I mean, like, Mr. Anderson's a great wrestler here in new TNA.
Well, yeah, he's a good wrestler, but they've just been hating each other since new TNA began. Spade has no respect for Spade. He has no respect for Trey Owens. And a guy like a young guy like that on the farm, he'd take that personally.
Jimmy Spade saying he's gonna beat Anderson so bad he'll be running away instead of running his mouth. Someone's typing in the background.
Well, advantage. Spade, Hudson can't wait to get his hands on Anderson against all odds.
And I honestly can't wait for either. I can't wait to see Anderson finally get some measure of a confidence.
What? Anderson will teach Spade to not mess with Anderson anymore. I'm sorry.
Spade's gonna teach Anderson some manners. Matt Spade saying he's no stranger to fights, no stranger to dealing with bullies. Ooh.
You say he's not just gonna beat him up, he's gonna break bones.
Make him bleed, make him suffer. Oh man, this goes beyond just a match. This goes beyond just a rivalry. This is hatred.
Your judge, your jury,
and ew,
executioner.
Yeah, just try him.
And there it is.
It's
official. Against all odds, these two men will go face to face, proving who will be better.
But later on Impact tonight, we're gonna have Samoa Joe and Kurt Angle continue in the best of five series. And like I said, at this rate, if these men keep fighting, they might not make it to Against All Odds. It's a good thing that they have a no contact clause.
Well, come. Yeah, I mean, I know what you're saying, but anyway, we're going to move on. And coming up next is going to be the Olympic gold medalist, Kurt Angle, taking on Samoa.
Samoa submission machine himself.
Here comes Kurt Angle.
Kurt Angle and Samoa Joe have really been deadlocked in this best of five series, trying to prove to the two of them who is the best wrestler in New-TNA, and therefore the world. Because here in New-TNA, we do have some of the best talent, the best wrestling talent on the planet. And these two men really do believe that they are the best wrestler in the company, but there can really only be one best wrestler, and Kurt Angle fully believes that is him.
Well, going back to that interview, Kurt Angle did claim that he will win tonight and go to sweep the series at Against All Odds, but Joe has not made a single claim yet.
Yeah, Joe has only said that he's in this for the whole series, good or bad. He's not really focused on what just happens in one match. Joe really hasn't. Something that some people might notice that is that Angle's been running his mouth the whole time. Joe hasn't really said anything.
Well, here comes.
Speaking of which, here he comes, the silent beast himself, the Samoa submission machine, Samoa Joe.
Well, as he said before, Kurt Angle's been running his mouth for them, but Joe has said nothing. Maybe Joe was planning to do what he wanted to do to Kurt Angle for the night.
And while most of you might still point out that Kurt Angle has had more success as far as number of world titles or a couple of achievements here in the professional wrestling industry, let's not forget that on the first count, Joe was undefeated for just about 18 months when he debuted in TNA, and he was a world champion for nearly 2 years with a company that we cannot mention.
Wow.
So Joe is no slouch himself.
These two men have been on it. The fans are on their feet.
They want to see this great match go down, and I can't wait. I'm as pumped as the rest of them. Let's get it on.
Here we go.
Now both men staring out of the circle and measuring each other.
They're just studying each other to see what we'll do. Who will strike first? Who will come out top in this match? We will find out right now.
We'll blink. Oh, now,
Angle taunting Joe might not be the smartest strategy. And Joe got up right next to Angle's face and making a taunt of his own.
And
go down.
Play the SmackDown sign back there. Oh.
Oh, wait a minute.
Here we go.
Good lockup.
Samoa Joe has it by neck counter.
He's going to the Angle has a counter. Joe has a counter of his own. And tied her in the wrist lock. Angle counters into a rear waist lock. Steve, who do you think is going to go ahead in this match? And as Joe goes with that nice counter, followed up with an explosive suplex.
Going back to your question, who will win? I would have to say Kurt Angle. I mean, he's a great athlete. He's a numerous multi-time world champion.
One count.
He's a multi-time world champion. Kurt Angle, when you speak of him, you just think of real wrestling. Oh, wait. Oh!
Powerbomb there by Samoa Joe. Really impressive.
But anyway, I'm going to ask the same question to you. Who do you think will come out top in this match?
Well, I'm not sure so much as just in this match or in the whole... I'm going to say in this match the same person I think will have said in the whole series. I'm going to say that it's going to be Samoa Joe. I mean, Samoa Joe... Nice news right there. There's really no one else like in the professional wrestling industry.
Well, here's a cover
breakup. No one else has that combination of strength, speed, size, and skill that Samoa Joe brings to the table.
Here comes the knife chops.
Total package, Joe, with those nice knife edge chops in the corner. Look at that.
Look at this.
Things are look at speedy and security. Like I said, that's the speed. That's the quickness.
Samoa Joe, very athletic. He's very athletic in this match, and I mean, Samoa Joe just come out of nowhere with that nice backflip, hit the head, and now he's just going to get him in a neck hold. Right? Oh,
look at this camel clutch with a pseudo camel clutch with the arm capture. Very nice there by Joe. Really just kind of isolate Angle. Wait a minute, now Joe with that hard kick to the gut, and wait a minute, what's this?
Oh shit! Oh, here's a cover.
One,
two,
no. Shades of one of Joe's great rivals, Jushin Thunder Liger. Wait a minute, now what's this? Joe set an Angle up maybe for the Muscle Buster. Maybe he's thinking the Muscle Buster in the corner. He's got him up. He's got him up.
Wait
nobody.
A minute. Wait a minute.
Angle coming out. Amazing missile drop kick. I mean, to take nothing away from Angle, he is really one of the most, he is an extremely talented athlete in his own right.
Oh, now the triangle hold.
He's putting him in that triangle choke, and I was trying to drain the life out of Samoa Joe, because that was what... That's the only thing, the result you might be able to get out of Samoa Joe to play on the victory and submission match, because I've never really, it's almost impossible to get a man like Samoa Joe to tap out.
Samoa Joe not looking too good, but I have to say, this is the best strategy for Kurt. I mean, Kurt Angle, you need to go for the legs for Samoa Joe since he's a big guy, I mean, and now he's just going to choke out the life of all of it.
And, you know, the guy likes Samoa Joe. You can't really try to outpower him. And his speed, you can't really try to outmaneuver him. So you can't
Wait a minute.
Like I said, you can't really outpower Samoa Joe. He just proved that there by powering out of Joe's, or of Angle's, or Angle Joe. Wait a minute, Angle had a scouted leg.
Well, Kurt Angle is like, going to try to slow him down and wear him out. As you can see now, he's going for the leg. Wait a minute. Oh.
Got the ankle lock. No, Joe might still be getting his bearings after that oxygen the brain he might have lost.
Wait a minute!
I'm ready.
It's locked in.
It's locked in tight. Nail of the ring, nowhere for Joe to go. USB already.
Well, this is going to be your match.
Is this the end?
Hurt Angle.
The neck locked in tight on Joe.
Samoa Joe is in the middle of the ring. This has to be it.
And this Joe's got nowhere to go, and Angle's trying to break his ankle.
He's going to shatter the ankle.
Going to snap that in two, unless Joe fights side of it. Joe's not going anywhere. He's got nowhere to go.
Fans are on their feet.
Wrenching, like, God, he's been in that hold so long. Already, jeez. He's just trying to flit out of it. You can see him struggling. You can see the pain in his eyes.
Oh wait!
Wait a minute! He does!
He's breaking out of that.
Joe breaks out of the ankle. I've very rarely seen a man do that. Samoa Joe not going quietly into the night.
Ooh, what a clothesline, man.
It looked like a hard hand to me.
And now he's working on the leg.
Turned out on the leg.
Wait a minute.
Oh, no. Oh, dear.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I don't like where this is going. One little titty. This is going well at all.
High pitch. Oh! No! Jeez. Jesus Christ.
Jeez. First he made Joe Soprano, now he's going to break his legs off.
That's going to hurt.
It's going to hurt like a motherfucker.
You got to figure that's detrimental to Joe's power-based strategy and his striking style.
Turn angle just taunting, getting ready. But wait a minute, Samoa Joe, back up.
His face is, wait a minute, no. Angle drops him again with a hard drop kick.
No angle. Focusing on the leg again. Now Angle just working over the knee in the leg of Samoa Joe, just trying to take him out. I don't know if it's really the best, or that might be the best strategy, just trying to weaken the man's power base. And wait a minute, now Joe working the leg.
Now Joe, hook to the eye.
That thumb to the eyes. Wait a minute. German suplex.
That ain't going to be too well. Now, Kurt Angle, like we said before, he's just going on the leg now. He's setting up for that angle lock again. But
hey, look at this. Angle's got him in the corner. What's he thinking here? I'm just pounding his back with forearms. And wait a minute, what's this?
Whoa, German suplex!
Just rebounding his momentum out of the corner.
I think Kurt Angle's ready. Are we going to see another ankle lock?
I don't know. I mean, Kurt Angle, he's been wearing Joe down. You got to figure that's in his plan somewhere.
Now he's working on the back.
Back, legs, just kind of... Like I said, the power base. I mean, if you work down the back, you can't really do the hand lock scoops. If you work down the back, Wait a minute.
Where's Kurt Angle going?
Angle, where are you going?
Wait a minute.
I saw
Oh my God!
He actually hit the buzzsaw. I can't believe it. Well, Joe not having any of it.
Joe
back to his feet. Joe, that huge arm dragon. Now with the knee stomp.
What the hell? Samoa Joe is now just pissed off.
Samoa Joe didn't take that moonsault too kindly. He's just, you can see him favoring the leg, but he's just going after Kurt Angle. Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
I'm not sure what you call it, but you call it a nasty one. I know that much, and now... Those hard kicks to the chest and the face.
Oh, Joe has been getting his ass kicked during the whole match, I have to say. But now he's coming back. Now working on the legs of Kurt Angle.
He started this match in control of the Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle gained control for a while. Now Samoa Joe back fully in control of this match.
Now Samoa Joe trying to shake some light back into his legs. Now to Samoa Joe and the SmackDown on Kurt with those huge knife-edge chops.
Oh, look at this, yeah!
Oh, my rope! He has the rope by his arm! Two! Three!
Freaking up! Four!
Oh!
I want to get disqualified, Joe. Now, Joe. With another standing camel clutch on Arm Catcher Camel Clutch, just working over Kurt Angle. Just trying to weaken him. Or control through the back of Joe's corner. His leg doesn't even seem to bother him. Joe's totally in control of this match.
Now, Samoa Joe. Oh, wait. What is this?
Powerbomb!
Oh, Jesus!
Like I said, no one really brings that combination of strengths, power, and skill that Joe brings, and you're seeing it right now. And what's this? Look at this! Another Tiger Suplex. Now look at this, what's he got here?
Wait a minute.
Now the Tiger Bomb!
We seen that before earlier in the match. Is Samoa Joe going to send him up?
Now what's Joe got in mind? No, wait! Joe's
going to
do the rest of the
match.
Oh, dude! Ring, no more Kurt Angle, Joe, he's going to fight out of it.
We've seen Samoa Joe in the same situation in the middle of the ring, but can
Angle fight out of this, or Joe fight out of the ankle? I don't know.
Now that FTF is locked in the middle of the ring.
Joe's struggling. He can't. Angle's struggling. He's fighting, but he's fading. Joe might be able to get this one here. It's the STF. He's got locked in that STF. There could be no escape for Angle.
Angle's fading.
What? Kurt Angle just trying to get out of this, but I don't think Kurt Angle's going to be getting out of this anytime soon.
Angle's fighting, but he just can't. He doesn't have the strength to get out of a
hole. Wait a minute!
Oh!
Strength! He does have the strength! Oh!
That was a huge shoulder attack, locking the big Samoan down. And Angle's back in control with that big shoulder drop right across the big elbow drop right across
never,
the back. Now,
you should never let out a Kurt Angle.
Now, wait a minute, Joe. Look at this. Joe with a huge slam into a cover.
Cover up ropes.
On the rope.
Kurt Angle managed to get his foot on the rope. Oh!
Oh! Angle has got it. Huge!
Oh! And another one!
Okay, maybe a third.
This, what?
Oh,
what
German.
The German suplex? Kurt Angle is all fired up here, ladies and gentlemen.
He's coming back in this match. Back and forth, these men have gone. And wait a minute. Now, Angle, or Joe's a little dazed, and now
another German suplex by Kurt Angle.
Now, Angle's back in control. Once Angle got planned here, he's putting Joe up on the top turnbuckle. Oh,
no, wait a minute. Joe going up high. No.
Oh my god.
Belly to belly off the top turnbuckle. Here's the cover. One, two.
Yeah, no.
I thought that was three. That had to be three, but Samoa Joe had enough strength to kick out.
Whoa,
German.
God!
Look at that! This match, oh! Jawbreaker. Throwing Joe.
Joe, another one of those slams. Didn't go for the cover this time. Now kicking Angle in the face.
Here's the cover.
Cover, kick out of one. Two.
Oh!
Angle fights out.
I thought that was three, but...
That was going to be it, man. Back and forth, these men have gone, beating each other to a
pulp. Bulldog!
Oh, Shining Wizard Bulldog combination out of the corner.
There's a cover. One, two, three, no!
Oh, cover, no.
These both men.
Huge and scurry!
These men are just going back and forth.
And now, what's this? What's the guy planned here? Look at this.
Ooh.
Big headbutt in the back of the head. That's why he never headbutted Samoa.
With the back of the neck. Oh, God.
Angle fights out. Now with another huge belly.
Another.
Crashing across the ring and now a huge shoulder tackle.
These both men just going everything they got.
A huge belly again. Turning Joe inside out. Now Angle going top turnbuckle.
Top turnbuckle. Oh,
splash!
God, I am just shocked. These both men are doing absolutely great.
Oh, jeez, the elbows, the back. You think Kurt Angle's actually able to hit both of his top rope moves in this match? I mean, that's almost never happened. That's usually the turning point in the match. It might still be, because Angle is currently in control. That drop the canal. Here it comes.
Oh, the three German suplex at... Three! I think Kurt Angle is going to set him up again for an ankle lock. Wait!
Oh!
Angle!
Slam!
There it is! A big time! Angle slamming.
Yeah, that could be it. Hey, this could be the end of the match.
Here's a cover. One, two, three! It is over. Kurt Angle.
I couldn't really say anything against Kurt Angle after that huge victory. Just a big hardcore match. This is what I love about wrestling. This is what I believe wrestling alone can sell. This is two good men putting out a great match. And that is the whole professional wrestling in and of itself. When Angle went over for that big Angle slam as you just saw, and now Angle leads 2-0 in the series.
Kurt Angle surely has been doing fine here on New Impact, picking up a big time win. I voted for this guy to win this match. He did. You saw him go off the top rope. kicks, rock kicks.
My money's still on Joe though to take the series. We still have five matches, or we still have another three matches Joe could catch him in. We certainly don't have Angle still able to celebrate this victory tonight. Kind of rubbing it in the face of the fans. The fans ain't happy. I mean, they had nothing wrong with the match, but the man of honor's the wrong man just was victorious.
Wait a minute.
Well, now Suspect and Nair are getting ready to hit the town. And
what the hell? What is Suspect wearing? Whoa!
Guns.
Wait a minute. Alex Shelley and
Curtis Saban, the TNA Tag Team Champions, Motor City Machine Guns, cocking their opponents for against all odds. Saban showing respect, saying they think we give them a top notch performance.
Motor City Machine Guns, like, I guess they're just showing them respect for them, and against all odds, it isn't going to be.
They're not going to be all bloody buddy.
And against all odds, I mean, like, these two tag teams are going at it. And it won't be one. It isn't going to be one for pure respect. It ain't going to be about friends, good times, and it'll be about the championships and the men standing in their way.
Like Darren said, they never really faced a team quite like the Pope and Suspect, the Million Dollar Congregation. They have Suspect laying it all out, but plain and simple. They have something they want. They're not friends, they're opponents. So I say I wouldn't have it any other way.
Oh, Motor City Machine Guns saying they will still be tag team champions at against all odds.
And, you know, maybe they will. I mean, they might be able to pull it off. I mean,
wait a minute. Oh, Jeff Hardy's!
Hardy coming out of nowhere.
He's getting revenge.
How is Hardy even standing?
I don't know, but wait, no! Oh!
Jesus!
Oh my god!
Brooks got put through that tail and they're just put his head through that car window. And
tensions are building up these two men, but coming up next is our main event!
Phenomenal Angels reunite, take on Oshujax and his protege, Ryan Sparks. Get some EMTs out there for crying out loud. And someone got hurt.
We're in it. This thing got hurt. We're
JJ
Styles.
All set for this main event. He needs to stay in control heading into against all odds.
Well, I have to say this. I am rooting for Team Oshujax in this. I mean, you got to give Oshujax some credit for being our world champion here in New Impact. He's doing a great job being our champion.
I guess you'd say that, but I think the belt needs to go back to the guy who's
willing to defend the belt, but also stay with the rules and admit that if someone is able to beat him, this I would have a problem being the better man, with another guy being the better man. Oshujax is a coward and a scoundrel to the very end. His ego drives him in everything he does, and refuses to allow him to accept the word Nick defeat. And
the fans,
what's wrong with it?
Fans are on their feet for this big main event tonight. Wait a minute!
What the hell were those jacks on for?
Yes! No!
AJ had him scouted. AJ knew he was coming.
AJ was ready for it.
AJ fighting him off though, and AJ with the kick to the chest. AJ's taking those checks.
Well, I have to say this. This is a preview for against all odds.
AJ just laying the smackdown on this tag match. Hasn't officially started yet, but AJ Styles currently not waiting for the tag match. And oh, the hurricane run out of the until the world DDT there by AJ Styles. Now AJ, but now Oshujax getting back in control.
Well, oh!
Now
Big
boot turning AJ inside out. Now just going to work on the smaller man. So now,
where's the rest of Team Oshujax and AJ?
With a huge air raid siren there by Oshujax. They're stomping out AJ.
Oshujax now just taking it to AJ Styles.
Oshujax back in control. Wait a minute. No,
oh!
Quad Slam. Just turning him out. Inside out.
And they go, wait a minute. He has the chair. Well, wait a minute. AJ Styles. Oh, God.
Oh, my. He's a huge dive to the outside. Just...
my God. Yeah, he has the chair. Oh,
man. Oshujax just got clocked.
He's out, wait a minute.
Oh, jeez.
Oshujax back up. AJ doesn't know.
He's got the ladder. Oh, no. Oshujax, though. Back in control. Oh, my. What a slam. You know, dear, just these men back and forth. Oh, cracked AJ in the head with the ladder. I don't like the idea of Oshujax having this ladder at all. And he's just really just laying into AJ Styles in this offense. Oh, again. Oh, no. Look out, fans. Here's a souvenir. This Styles just went crashing into the concrete. And I was like, and there were no pads on that concrete. Oh, AJ Styles just feeling woozy. AJ Styles in trouble. Now Oshujax
stomped. Oshujax now just, what's the, oh shit.
Oh, jeez, what's the table?
Wait a minute, AJ's back up.
No, no, AJ's back up. He just got him in a big like suplex. Oh, sharp edges of the table. And really, people are always talking about the problem with, I don't want to go through the table, but it's plenty dangerous on the underside of the table as well. And he's got that table set up. I don't like that. Don't like that one bit. And look at this. Whoa, what a huge hurricanrana on the floor there. AJ Styles to Oshujax. Back and forth. AJ finally seems in control.
God, these two men are just going at it. This is supposed to be a tag match.
A tag match. This match hasn't even started. I mean, I don't even know if they're partners. The Cardinals will have to make this a singles match. The man has even left and Oshujax is a crack of that steel chair. We have Oshujax, or AJ going for that triple jump. Oh! Yeah, that's out of it. Good lord.
Jeez, that's going to leave a mark.
Oh, jeez, Oshujax, the big German suplex. They almost landed on the ladder. Oshujax setting up this ladder. I don't like this at all. Oshujax now.
Oshujax is
not... AJ just knock it.
Oh!
He will not stay down. Maybe he should, though. Now it's Jax.
Jax.
AJ.
Slam! Landing on the chair and the ladder, I believe. And Oshujax setting it up. Oh!
Backbreaker.
Oh!
It just bounced off the ladder.
It ain't good at all. This is not good. Jax going up high, but wait a minute. Here comes
Styles. He's meeting him up on the top, and no! Oh, my!
Fans are on their feet. There's the hot girl again.
Jax haven't moved the ladder, the table. Well, I don't like how this is going. I don't like what Jax is playing. The fans are...
my fans God, are the fans are on their feet!
Oh,
this is...
fans,
wait a minute! What the hell?
Oh my god!
Holy shit!
That killed him! That killed him! Good God Almighty! God is my witness, he's broken in half!
Oh my God! Get EMTs out here!
And look at him! You look at him being pushed out of this arena! You look at the man who did that, AJ! It was me!
Going back to this replay, AJ Styles just...
I can't just believe what happened. Good lord, it's... Ugh, that was tough to look at. That was horrifying.
I hope AJ makes it out for the Against All Odds match. I really
hope that he gets next to Against All Odds, because goddammit, someone's got to get Oshujax what's coming to him.
I mean, Oshujax had to prove something, and he did.
This isn't how you prove it. You don't prove him so that you can beat a man by jumping him from behind and almost putting him in a hospital. You prove you can beat a man by getting in the ring with him and doing it man-to-man, fair, face-to-face. This is disgusting.
Calm down. I mean, like, this was great for Oshujax. I mean, he wanted AJ Styles to know that Oshujax is not coming without a fight. And he made that. And he's hoping that AJ Styles doesn't make it to Against All Odds, but...
Because he's afraid. He's afraid of AJ.
How is he afraid?
That's why he's doing what he's doing. Because he doesn't want to face him off, but because he doesn't want to go with AJ head-to-head. He has to try and take him out beforehand. He has to make sure that AJ can't make it to the match. I don't even know what our main event's going to be. I mean, is Daniels going to be a handicap match?
I don't know what's going on, but it looks like we're going to go to an Oshujax now in the ring, and...
I don't even know what to say. Oh man, Daniels. Well, I don't want to be either one of these men when Daniels gets his hands on them. I mean, Daniels just... You gotta figure Daniels is seething after Oshujax tried to murder his best friend. The man that Daniels has named one of his children after. And after what Oshujax did to AJ Styles, I can't imagine Daniels is in a good mood right now.
Alright, I'm still shocked. I'm just still shocked what happened with AJ Styles. I mean, like, I can't
believe that happened.
I mean, Oshujax did after what Oshujax did, he got a mic and said that's what he deserved. That's why you don't mess with the world champion Oshujax, and I have to agree with him on that.
AJ Styles deserved that? Are you out of your mind?
He deserved what he had coming. Now, I don't think he deserved getting through a table, but off the ladder, I think he deserves. But AJ Styles...
20 feet! Samir is going to break his back! Oshujax is insane!
Oshujax has proven why he is world champion, why he is the best in this company, why...
He's a champion because he's a gutless coward? That's all this showed to me.
We're going to have a handicap match now as AJ gets sent to the hospital.
Daniels is just going on to pieces, Josh Jackson. Man, Daniels, he's too angry. He's really formulated a plan.
Wait a minute!
The hell?
Teddy Long?
Long's coming out. What's this?
What is this?
Teddy, can we get Teddy? Thank you. What in the world? I hope Teddy has something to say about all this. What the hell just went down?
He's the world champion, Teddy. World champion.
That doesn't mean he just do what he did. That's wrong.
What?
That's right, Teddy. Make him pay for his actions and throw him out of this arena.
That is unfair. Oshujax had to prove something. Teddy Long needs to redo that decision.
He's the general manager. He doesn't need to do anything except bring some justice around here. There's no reason Daniels has to have a handicap match. More importantly, there's no reason.
Wait a minute. What is he?
Another preview Against All Odds.
Falls
for his title.
This is not fair!
What happens when you try... This is what happens, motherfucker. Yes, kicking you out for almost murdering a man, that's not bias at all. Get the fuck out of here.
Unfair. Oceanjax is a world champion, and you have to respect him. Respect the world champion, and don't throw him out of this match. I will back everything. I will back up Oceanjax and everything that just happened here. I wrote it down. This is unfair for Oceanjax.
Well, we're going to get this the singles match underway now between Ryan Rex and Christopher Daniels. We've got to figure Daniels going to take out the Hardy's Gary. Daniels going to take out some of his aggression that he feels for what happened to AJ on Oshujax's protege here. Cover, no. Rex able to kick out it too. And this is just, this is really just very solid back and forth. Daniels is in control right now against Brian Rex, and I'm glad Daniels has a fair fight now. I mean, that was just what Oshujax did was just reprehensible.
No. This Oshujax, like I said, he had to prove that AJ should never mess with the world champion. He had to prove that he would not make it against all odds. Now, if he doesn't make it against all odds, that means Oshujax doesn't have to defend his title.
If he doesn't make it to against all odds, then Oshujax will probably be having to face heavy fines for screwing the fans out of their world title main event match. Well, there'll be repercussions for Oshujax one way or the other. And I still can't believe you're agreeing with what Oshujax did.
Because I respect the world champion and his actions.
I'd respect the world champion if he did something once in a while worth respecting. Trying to murder a man is not worth respecting. Back to the match, Christopher Daniels now working over the arm of Ryan Rex, trying to take the strength out of his arms for the rest of your face.
Going back to the Oshujax, all these pathetic people need to know that Oshujax is a wrestling god.
He's a wrestling... he's a coward. He's a weasel. That's all he is.
No. These fans need to realize that you should never mess with Oshujax and what he does. He's the best in the world at what he does in New Impact.
Okay, and is what he does being a coward, being a gutless shit, a worm of a man who attacks him from behind because when he knows that he can't beat them one-on-one, Daniel continues to be in control of this match.
There's a couple. One, two.
Rex powers down.
This is unfair. I mean, just because of one action Oshujax did, he gets kicked out of the arena. This is totally unfair for what Teddy Long did.
That's the assault off the ladder. It's the whole thing attacking him before the match started, and this goes back to what he did. It was the same thing he did when he assaulted him last week. Nice move there by Daniels. I mean, Oshujax, when he made that whole tirade about how running down the company, running down all its competitors, you didn't hear him down his soapbox last week when he insulted Kool-Aid, he insulted me, he insulted everyone in this company. Daniels needs to stay in control of this match. It's been dominant. A dominant performance here by Daniels.
Well,
and there is time someone beats him, and that's time someone made Oshujax pay for his actions once in a while with a huge...
Hey, nobody needs to pay anything to Oshujax. Alright, everybody in the back, and even all these people, all these pathetic people that watch, need to know that Oshujax is the man to not be messed with. A man that will destroy everything in his path.
And there's a way to do, and there's and there are ways to do that. But the way he went about it tonight is just wrong. I can't stand this man as a world champion, and I can't wait for someone to finally put him in his place. Because someday, sooner or later, his time is coming. But damn, I'm still trying to stay in.
Anyway, we're gonna move on now to this.
Back suplex there by Daniels. I've been trying to go on your one. I've been trying to follow that too on the show, but
if you're a sudden man.
Because I'm trying to support Oshujax all the top rope.
Oh, a huge springboard neck breaker there by
Daniels broken up there.
Oh,
Rex able to play out of it.
Rex, I have to say that Rex is a lucky man to have the world champion as his mentor. He's learning from the best.
Yes, he's learning all about assaulting people from behind, taking cheap shots, picking up victories over people that weren't 100%, that weren't ready to fight you. Now, this strong lessons to be learning as the moral fiber of the future of this business. Well done, Oshujax. Well done. Now Rex going back. Now Rex starting to get control.
I have to say this, that Rex beat the number one contender in his debut match. Why? Because he had Oshujax as his mentor.
No, because Oshujax assaulted AJ Styles, repeatedly hit him with a steel chair, and then dropped him on his head with a waistline. Rex now going for the STF. Locks in tight, but he's got it in the ropes.
One, two.
He's got to break
up. He's disqualified.
No. Rex flipped out. Now Rex with a rear waist lock, and now Daniels counters that.
Rex needs to prove something to Oshujax that he's good, but he shouldn't be better than Oshujax. Nobody is better than Oshujax. Now Rex is just taking it to Daniels. Yes, that's right. Feel bad. That way you know that Rex is great now. He's doing awesome with his mentor, Oshujax.
Grounds that impressive springboard crossbody. One thing I'm feeling is a migraine. That's
one,
the greatness of
two,
Ryan.
Two!
Recover, Ryan. Oh. No. Ryan Rex kicks out. And then drop kick in. Now Daniel's thinking of going to top rope. Maybe, but no. Rex is able to get back to his feet in time. And now he's going to... Daniel's got a plan here. Maybe hit top rope, maybe they can superplex. With this, springboard into... Oh, it's more Hurricane Rana. Very impressive there by Daniels.
Here's the cover.
Cover. Uno.
Two.
No.
That's it, Rex. Do what you're doing. You're doing great. Fight back.
Ooh. Nice chop lock there by Daniels.
Oh.
Now a nice short arm close, or nice low clothesline there by Daniels. Now Daniels is firmly back in control of this match, and no, Ryan Rex able to counter.
Oh, that's it, Rex.
First land there by Rex.
That's really, he wanna know who he learned that from? He learned that from Oshujax.
And that's running dropkick there by Daniels, going to the outside, trying to save himself. I don't think that's going to work against a man like Daniels.
Rex is just taking a breather. This is good. He needs to focus on what he's going to do to Daniels. That way he can destroy him when he gets back in that ring.
Remember, Rex only has a 4, only has a 10 count. No! This is why I said that going outside would not be his safest strategy. With the longest reigning X Division champion in TNA history, there's really no place to hide. Now what's Daniels thinking? Oh, huge! The outside.
This is not looking good for Rex. Come on, Rex, dude. There you go.
Jesus, right on the steps.
Good. That's what he to Daniels deserves.
The Dragon is he? Crack the back of his head on that steel steps, and now back in the cap match. He's trying to give Daniels a concussion.
Good. He can get rid of the competition.
There's nothing good about trying to end a man's career. What the hell is this? Oh my God. What the hell is he doing? Oh my God. Jesus.
Good, Max. Good.
Oh, he's just trying to break his back.
Attaboy, Rex. Do what you're doing. You learn from the best of Oshujax. Keep it going.
Things also kind of that Oshujax teaching?
This is terrible.
This is
wrong every level. What the, he's exposed to turbo. Do something, ref. Ref, somebody.
This is perfect now.
How's he doing? Oh,
yes.
Somebody stop. Oh, my God. Okay, it's busted open.
This is what Daniels deserves. He's going to get the same fate as AJ Styles.
This is sick. This is giving him another concussion. Oh, my God. This is wrong. Wait a minute. Oh, no, another one of those.
Oh, here we've seen this on the steel steps.
Another crucifix.
Oh!
Oh, my God. And Rex is just in control.
Now, I just had to say this. You want to know who?
Rex. No. This is the same move put away Styles with last week. Rex, you're...
Oh! Hey! Who taught him? You want to know who taught Rex how to kick ass? Oshujax. Because you want to know why? There's the winner.
Well, I can't agree with his methods, but Rex picked up the victory. This is a sad night for TNA fans. The phenomenal... Well, remember, the phenomenal angel in serious medical attention. Just... And right... The game's been busted open. Might have a concussion. AJ Styles definitely go to the hospital. He might have a ruptured disc. So this is just... Well, this is terrifying. You ever hit that spinning neck breaker with the skull effer and wrap it all up.
I wonder how Daniels will be... I wonder how Daniel's gonna be feeling because now Daniels will be joining him in the hospital with AJ Styles. While Rex and Oshujax celebrate in the winner's circle.
I cannot. Against all odds, can't get here soon enough. Karma's coming for both these men. I can already feel it.
You just have to face the fact that both men are doing great.
That's definitely your definition of great. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Zach Shore.
And I am Steven.
And I'm sorry we couldn't end on a better note. Good night, everybody.